reactions, well, it causes reactions with chemicals, compounds and molecules, and pollutants are formed. So those are harmful pollutants, but those are in stratosphere, which are 12 to 16 kilometer miles away from the earth. Generated ozone is the ozone production you are doing in your clinic. So here again I would like to take you to the awareness that these four systems are there: cold plasma system, electrolytic system, UV ultraviolet system and corona discharge system. Corona discharge system is the, you must be aware of the thundering effect, there this corona discharge system is there. The same system we use by generating ozone in dental therapy and medical therapies. The ozone generators are there, which generate ozone because of the high electric fields between the electrodes. The air is passed away through that, and then ozone is produced. The reaction of oxygen molecule and one oxygen atom, it generates one ozone molecule. So in medical therapies, heavy concentrations are used. In dental therapies, there are specific concentrations. I will come to that point later on. Here again, I would like to insist, cold plasma system, ultraviolet system, and electrolyting. These are already in use, but very few people are aware of it. The food you are eating, that is already ozonated. The food which comes from mall, the instruments you are using in your practice, those are coming ozonated. Industries of dental equipment, instruments, those are using ozone for disinfection, as it is the 3000 times more effective disinfectant. And it is an antimicrobial, many properties are there, I'll take you through that topic. So, the corona discharge method is the system which is used for ozone generation. You can, I'll take you to the ozone generation later. What is ozonotherapy? How it is used in medical? It is successfully used in medical for dermatology, for the disc inflammations, spinal diseases, IV infusions are given, injectable ozone which is not used in dental, which is heavy concentration ozone, it is used for medical therapy. For dental therapy, there are different concentrations. So these all properties are there. The healing is faster, antimicrobial property, anti-inflammatory property, lesser analgesic effect is also there. It is a potent oxidant which breaks the, ruptures the cell wall by stopping the protein synthesis of the bacteria, and its action on ribosomes. So by that it kills all microbes, bacteria, protozoa, yeast and fungi and viruses. It is acting against all the microbes. Its detoxicant and biocompatibility with zero side effects makes it vulnerably, amazingly beneficial for all its multi-beneficial adjunct for all the treatments. Because there are some chemicals in your practice, like sodium hypochlorite is the best example. It is the best irrigation system worldwide accepted, but its only limitation is biocompatibility. But if you are using ozone along with that as an adjunct, supplementary effect can be brought. You can do an amazing result with 100% biocompatibility. 100% cannot be claimed, but we can go, as Dr. Herschel mentioned in his seminar, Dr. Vipin sir said that perfection can be brought by perfect practice. Going to next, forms of ozone. There are two forms of ozone, gaseous ozone and aqueous ozone. Gaseous ozone, direct gas application in your practice, you can generate ozone and you can apply the gas. I'll take you to that later on. It is a vast topic. Here it is, because of time shortage, it is not possible to take you through that. We will have an interaction session for that. Okay, aqueous ozone. Here, this I would like to explain more. Ozonated water you can use, drinking water. You yourself drink water, same you can ozonate it for patient, for the bottle you have in your clinic, that you can do ozonated water, you can use that so that its life is increased, your instruments, equipments, the efficiency is increased. Sodium hypochlorite I told you already. EDTA you can, you must be activating EDTA, you will come to a phenomenon as activating the irrigation systems. There you will come to know that you can ozonate EDTA inside the canal. But some protocols are there, some precautions should be followed, protocol should be followed, then only you can do it perfectly. Drinking water, chair-side water, even this year, carrier medium is there. You can, you must be using some carrier medium. If tooth aversion is there, what do you do? You use saline water. Then you can use ozonated water because it is again increasing the life. You have some limitations to use saline and saliva. It is very difficult to do that. So in such cases, I said that there should be initiative for this ozone, ozonated water or ozonated mediums. You can ozonate saline also. Injectable ozone with high concentrations for facial aesthetics can be future of dentistry. It is still practiced in abroad countries. It has not been practiced in India yet, but soon it will be coming to India. That's my belief. Safety protocol. This is the most important part because ozone is a misunderstood drug and ignored drug as it is a toxic and pollutant or non-beneficial because of its toxic reaction. Yes, it is toxic. It has its irritant action on the breathing airway, the mucosa lining of the lung. But if you are using its heavy concentration, they are not required. So 100%, earlier I said in the initiation, if you are doing things in right way, with the right protocols, with right learning, with right execution, you will get the benefit. You cannot say that ozone is beneficial, I'm using ozone and I'm not successful. You are not successful because you're not using the protocol. That is the reason. If you're using ozone, it is not about ozone, it is about any treatment in your dentistry. You're attending seminars, you're getting educated, you're already educated from a good college. There you've got many inventory, many success tools you have, many inventory tools you have which are which says the same thing, that protocols is the key for success. So here it is more, I would like to insist it more for protocols, because if you are not following protocols, patient will not accept this treatment. Suction tip should be used along with the ozone tip. Micro tips are available that you can use along with the ozone tip. Suction tip can be used, micro tips are available, all the micro tips available in your clinic, those are compatible with this ozone generator. You don't need to buy any accessory for this ozone generation and using ozone in your practice. So these will avoid the entry of the ozone gas to the airway, breathing airway, which will not cause those side effects. 100% it is safe to use with protocols. It is not safe because you are following the protocols. If you are using properly, then it is 100% safe. There are no side effects. No casualties up till now have been found. You already take care of pregnant patients, systemic conditions, bleeding disorders. So why not here? Here also you take the consent from the patient that I am using ozone for you. Then it is possible. So you have to take care of that. There is no allergy found up till now, but if you are that much caring for your patient, you can take the allergy test for ozone. It is available in pathology. So this is the only thing, irritation to breathing. Again, here one more thing is there. In dental, you are using topical applications of ozone. There are injectable ozone applications and heavy concentrations are there. IV infusion is there. Heavy concentration with oxygen cylinder is also there. Because when you are generating ozone in your clinic, you are using the air which passes through the corona distal system and ozone is generated. So there, if you want to use pure oxygen to avoid the side effects, it is not like that. That if you are using ozone, pure oxygen, like nitrous oxide sedation, you must have heard about it. It is a recent technology. So it is nothing like that. If you are using that ozone with pure oxygen and provision of oxygen cylinder, that also has these side effects when it is in heavy concentrations used in medical therapies. So in dental, we don't use IV infusions. Ozone chambers are also there for the lethal diseases as it is a natural antibiotic. You don't need antibiotics when it is injected in blood. So there you need this heavy concentration ozone, which also has these side effects, but if you follow the protocols, it is not going to harm the patient. Actually, it is very beneficial with the right concentrations in right treatment protocols. So these are the applications for dentistry. This will take almost 1 day or 3 day workshop detailing for this. I would just take in short. Scaling sensitivity or hypersensitivity, it is widely used, already successful. There is lot of literature, you can go through books up there. All the details are there. Teeth whitening, it is very useful. Aesthetic dentistry, that I'll show you one of my cases. Endodontics and endodontic irrigation, already I told you, sodium hypochloride, you can use it for making it more biocompatible. Gaseous ozone, you can use as final rinse after root canal. In periodontics, implant surgeries and many other surgeries, whatever surgical protocols are there, then you can use ozone. So for oral medicine, soft tissue lesions, it is having very high benefits. Patient comes to you that he says, I have an interview tomorrow, or he's having a flight or some important work tomorrow, and there is no such adjunct available which can heal his ulcer or superficial lesions. Do you have any for that treatment protocol, a medicine available, or a gel or anything, solution for that ulcer or the superficial soft tissue lesions? Oral submucous fibrosis, osteomyelitis, these lesions are there. Obviously, ozone again is limited for deep lesions. You cannot use ozone as treatment protocol. So soft, then you have to use injectable ozone. But again, it goes to medical therapy. It is not, up till now, it is not in research, it is in research and development for injectable ozone, and deep pressure techniques are also there. Many things are there. So those will come later on for deep lesions. So here you can use ozone alone as a treatment protocol for soft tissue lesions. Using ozone, only ozone, with no medicines, no antibiotics, no painkillers, no gels, you can treat soft tissue lesions completely, as faster as than others. Because ozone is a natural antibiotic, you don't need to, you must be giving heavy antibiotics in patients. So it is suggested, you must have gone through the guidelines of antibiotics by FDA or American Society or Indian Society. So giving heavy antibiotics, as much as you should avoid it, as well as you give therapeutic antibiotics and pre-medication antibiotics. Okay? If you are doing implants, if you are doing swelling cases, you give first antibiotics, then you call the patient. So there, how I have some questions with me. I have one article. So in that, some questions I'll ask you. We'll go through that. Patients come to you that they say, I don't want to take antibiotics. Such patients come to you. Some patients are there whom you prescribe. You take efforts for root canal, you take efforts for swelling cases, and those patients are not taking antibiotics at home. What solution you have? So firstly, you don't know what he is doing, because there is no check on that. So in such cases, at least you can do, you are already putting your efforts. So here you can use a natural ozone as adjunct, as ozone therapy is a alternative medicine. In medical therapies, it is used as an alternative medicine. There, if you are giving injectable ozone, no ozone consultant doctor is using antibiotics in injectable ozone therapies. It has not come to dental up till now. I hope it will come soon. So that part was remaining, so I focused on that. Ozone autoclaves are there, ozone chambers are there, and high concentration ozone. These are the future dentistry for in relation with the relevant to the ozone dentistry. These have not come up till now in dentistry. Even in other countries, US, UK, wherever dentists are using, facial aesthetic is there. Some UK dentists and US dentists are using ozone therapies, injectable ozone also, for facial aesthetics, the skin treatments. They get trained from dermatologists. And it is a FDA approved drug for treatments of spinal disc inflammations. So from there they get trained. and they use for facial aesthetics. This is one of my cases. In this patient, that patient told me that if you clean this all the things without sensitivity, then I'll do this treatment. Whatever you say, I'll pay you. It was not about charge. I want to tell you that how it is possible if you are not having solutions for sensitivity. Sensitivity patients come to you, right? You have solutions for sensitivity. Some people give crown for solution. He will send him to jail. Crowns are not suggested. It is actually not suggested just for sensitivity, I'm saying. He is not having anything vital to. Will you do tooth preparation in such cases? It is not suggested. So sensitivity is a very big issue in dental field. In such patients, what solutions you have? Even if you are giving him sensitivity gels or fluoride treatments or cavity, even if you are doing, so there are very few solutions. So here I have treated this case. After that, I used ozone. I'm not saying this scaling or the polishing part is because of ozone. That's not my claim. And I can't claim that also. That is because of the efforts. If you put efforts, you can do such cleaning and polishing. But after that, if sensitivity is there in that patient, what solution you have? Because that patient will come again and again, the recurrence of sensitivity will be there. Some might have hypersensitivity also. So this one example I can show you. One more is there. This composite filling was done by composite stock technique. How many of you are aware of oxygen inhibition layer for composites? So that is okay. If you go into details of composites, you will come to know the oxygen inhibition layer is there. When you are doing, you use layer techniques, you are doing layering, the most superficial part comes in contact with the oxygen in the air, and it inhibits the composite to fill that. And there are some inhibition property of the composite for the oxygen. So there, if you are using ozone, it will fail the treatment. Do you think that? It is not like that. So it is, again, protocols comes here. Again, protocols come here. If you are doing etching first, and then you are using ozone, then that oxygen inhibition layer thing will be there. Then that oxygen inhibition layer will fail the treatment. Because you are using ozone after etching, that property will come in the activation. So it is suggested to use ozone before etching, rinse it off, and then follow your protocols, whatever protocols you are following for your composite filling, all the skills, efforts you put, and then you can do a successful composite filling. This is one example. This is dentonomics, the economics part I said. It is very less aware for people nowadays. Everyone wants to make money. So it is very big question nowadays. Some articles are there after GST application. So economics of dentistry, I have some details on this. I'll put up this in short, that if you want to generate money in your practice, what are the options? You get educated from some college, you come in the practice, you do at your level best. I'm not saying the best dentist or the earlier dentist, I'm not going into that. Whoever is doing in the right direction with the right intentions, he is successful according to me. Because it is not about that what quality protocol you are following. If you are doing it with the right intentions, it's good. It will give you good results because your intentions are good. And your intentions are to learn, to improve it for your future. You will improve it. 100% you will improve it by improvising your skills. One day you will reach the perfection. It will take time. But as he said, take baby steps. Go slowly, but come to the perfection. The perfect practice will take you to the perfection. So this scarcity of skills, knowledge, inventory and science, this comes from the college. aids to you practice, then you attend courses, seminars, get educated, still it remains there. A doctor is always a practicing learner. Resources and its right use. The resources you are using in clinic, do you have check on that? You don't have time to keep a check. There are softwares in your clinic. Are you using those? Is there a SMS sent to your dealer, whoever is that person, of the stock available in your clinic? There is very less time for all these things, but it is the reason of the economics of your practice. So there we are lagging. Even if I am lagging, there we are lagging. Because of that, your economics is affected. It's very important. It is the right of patient. There is an article for patient that what are the rights of patient. Like we make associations for dentists, we make associations for our struggling part, our attacks. What are the associations for patients? Patients are coming to you, trusting you as a doctor. Nowadays, they are claiming that doctors are not doing good things. Leave that part. That is negativity. But if you take positivity, you yourself is claiming that you are doing the most moral thing in the society. So what best efforts are taken for the patient's benefit? That is my concern. So patient should get his right, get the right protocols used, get the quality material used for whatever fees he is paying. There is no check in India or in some other countries also for the prices, for the cost. Dr. Vipin sir mentioned that in his seminar that there are fees controversies are there. People come together, make some protocols, bring a list that is followed or not, there is no check. So I don't believe in that. So whatever is done in the clinic, that is the true thing. So that I am saying that patient benefit you should concern. Obviously you are concerned, I am not saying that, but this resources thing brings me to tell you that. Resources and its right use. So because of unawareness, because of not keeping check on that, your inventory is stock available. Sometimes it is not available, so you use some adjunct treatment for that, adjunct material for that. This happens, and you don't have choice because he is in pain. The patient is in pain, so you have to do that. That's my concern. I'm not saying you are doing some wrong. So coming to management of failures and limitations, what management or what protocols you have for your failures? Do you analyze your failure? We fail to do that because we don't accept our failure. It is the first step to accept it. Accept your failures, work on it, analyze it. Just like I showed you my cases, that it's my success. So why I'm not showing failure cases? Failures are there. So at least if you're not showcasing it to your society, your people, at least showcase it to yourself. Keep a section of failure. Manage it. There should be a treatment protocol for every failure case, and then that learning starts. Here you have come for learning. Even I had come for learning session. Growth is there through this, right? So that learning will start from the management of your failure cases. You have to keep a section for this. That is management of failure and limitations. Whatever treatments or materials you are using, limitations are there. Ozone dentistry limitations, I'll tell you. There are limitations, I told you, toxic irritant effects. Then ozone cannot be used for deeper lesions. Ozone cannot be used for injectable therapies. You need antibiotics in dentistry. If you are using ozone, obviously you should not give heavy antibiotics, but you will require antibiotics. So those are the limitations. Those are the limitations for ozone. So this is the management of limitation, that your plan of action for patients in which ozone is not allowed or limitation is there, your plan of action should be ready. Increase your patient education and awareness. How much work on this is done? Right now, recently, many institutions are doing this thing. It's a very good thing for us that it is done in institutions. Some NGOs are doing, but how much it is done by dentists? It's a very good concern and it should be taken to a larger level.
because we ourselves complain for this and we don't take initiatives for that. It's our thing, we should do that in our clinic. When our patient is coming, you yourself is limiting your treatment protocols. That you are telling him that this is the right thing for you, this is the, your treatment. So there comes this decision of patient education and awareness. Decision making and making patient benefits first, already we have covered that. Along with other adjuncts, ozone is definitely a promising therapy for you to bring harmony to your patients and dental health, dental operatory environment, and for staff safety. So this last point, staff safety, is your safety is also there, staff safety is there. The staff asks you for their safety? Because when you're fumigating your clinic, you're using some chemicals. So does your staff go through for the safety protocols? Because if you're fumigating your clinic with the fumigating agent, you have to keep your clinic at least closed and one should not enter it, so that all effect will be there, and then once it is gone, then you will start the job at least. So your assistant is not aware of it. There is very less education on it. Then cross-infections are there. Patient to dentist, dentist to dentist. Multiple dentists are working together. Staff to dentist, staff to patient, and patient to patient. Hospital to clinic and cross-infection. You must have gone through this phenomenon in infection control. So there this thing comes, staff safety protocol. So if you are using ozone in your clinic, it can be used as fumigation agent safely, completely. When you are sitting in the clinic, you can do ozone fumigation. You don't need to close it or keep it or watch or something like that. There are 100% safety benefits of ozone for fumigation. After that comes, if you are using ozone in your practice, the staff is completely safe for the contaminations and infection protocols. So let us conclude this as the most boring part, therapeutics. This is my initiative as Dent Ozone India, the awareness program for ozone thing all over the world. I'm doing some seminars in Egypt also, and going further. This is my email address and my contact number. If you have any queries, you want to discuss any pieces, if you want to know that ozone can be used in this case or not, you can send. We will have a discussion on that. If you are interested, I will join you for my free seminars on those. Free.
Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah. Any questions?
Everybody, a round of applause, please, first.
Any questions? I have my article of questions. It is already sent on WhatsApp to many people. So if you have some questions, it's fine. Otherwise, I will ask you some questions. You have any questions?
Anybody, any queries? Any questions? Or should we ask sir to ask us? Sir, please go ahead. Ask us a few questions.
No, I'm just...
Okay. Alright, so I think if they have anything to ask you, they'll definitely WhatsApp you. Or please note down his email ID and mobile number, everyone. Thank you so much, sir. It was very informative.
Yeah. Okay.